Hello and welcome to this PalmSens video. Today we're going to talk about the multiplexer. So we often get the question, what is the multiplexer and especially what's the difference with a multi-channel device? A multi-channel device is a potentiostat, so for example our multi-PalmSens 4 or multi-MSTAT 4, where each of the connections in the housing is an individual potentiostat. That means you can start the same or different techniques at the same or different time in individual cells. We also have an application note that describes how to use the multi-channel devices actually in the same cell. You can find the link to that application note in the description below. But today we want to focus on the multiplexer. So what does a multiplexer do? Well, a multiplexer is usually something that people choose to increase the efficiency of their potentiostat with a low investment, because a multiplexer is a series of switches that allows you to connect a single potentiostat to multiple cells. The multiplexer will switch between the experiments between the different cells. So you could perform a cyclic voltammetry on cell 1 and then switch to cell 2, perform a cyclic voltammetry, etc. Let's first have a look at how we connect it, and then I can tell you how you can connect, what different options are there for connecting your cell. Let's say I have my PalmSens 4 and I would like to connect it maybe for a longer overnight automated measurement. So I want to connect up to 2 cells. Important is the potentiostat that you want to use needs to have an auxiliary port. At the moment we can offer the PalmSens 4 or the MSTAT 3 Blue with auxiliary ports. These are then potentiostats that are actually compatible with multiplexers. You require the matching Y cable. So if you are buying a multiplexer from us, please tell us which potentiostat you want to use with that multiplexer so we can give you the right Y cable, which is included in the price of the multiplexer. As usual, you will get these cables with your order. Then I connect the auxiliary port and the sensor cable port both with the Y cable, and then I connect that Y cable with the input of the multiplexer. You see here there are these 2 pins that will make the plug lock in, and then so it sits fixed on your potentiostat. You can press the 2 buttons at the side to release it again. Now you have connected your PalmSens 4 to your multiplexer. Okay, that's one side of the connection, but there is more to connect because you also want to connect your multiplexer to yourself. We have different connection options, and I would start with the most popular connection option that I would consider as the most versatile. These are our double shielded cables, and they are basically the same cables that you use for our potentiostats. So the ones that you get for the single channel potentiostats. On one side you have the connection for the multiplexer, and on the other side you have a lot of 2mm banana plugs that are labeled as well. So every bundle is labeled with a channel number. There's a 3 on there. And each single lead is then also labeled with their function and channel number. For example, that says W3 for the working electrode of the 3rd channel. Each of these cables is capable of supporting 4 cells. You need then 2 of these cables to support the full 8 cells that the multiplexer is capable of supporting. So this multiplexer, the MUX8, has connections for 8 cells. Then you see you have for every cell, you have the working electrode 1. This is the 1st channel, so this is the working electrode 1, the counter electrode 1, the reference electrode 1, and the ground. Then you have also a yellow lead. So this is important when you have a potentiostat that does have a sense lead, because then you also will require this one. But for example, when I connect a PalmSens 4, I just don't need it. This is a lot of cables, but these cables already show you that you have also a lot of options how to connect to your cell. You can have 8 individual cells, each with 3 electrodes, a reference, counter, and working electrode. Of course, as usual, you can make this a 2-electrode setup by having a working electrode and a combined counter-reference electrode. Another option you have is to switch off the multiplexing only for the reference and counter electrode, and you only multiplex the working electrodes. This means you would use multiple working electrodes in the same cell that share all the same reference and counter electrode. Let me show you other cable connections. We have standard cable from electronic suppliers, and this is just a high density cable where each pin of this plug is pulled out into a single lead that has a number, but this is the number of the pin. And then you have a ferrule at the end, so it's easy to solder this cable to something. So this would be more recommended if you want to make your own setup. Another good solution for making your own setup are our screw terminal connectors. So these are now very small and they make it very easy for you to organize your own connections. You have here all these little screw terminals, so you know you can screw them open, put a cable in there and screw them tight again. And every pin has a screw terminal. This is another way how you can organize your own cables. No worries, you will find in the manual the pin outs, so what every pin does. So it's easy to arrange them like this. Then another option that we have is that you directly connect screen print electrodes. Maybe you're familiar with our PSCon that allows you directly to connect screen printed electrodes to your potentiostat. And this is in principle the counterpart for the multiplexer. So you see here, we have one plug that I can just connect to the multiplexer. And then there are four SPE connectors on here. And just to already show you some examples, these connectors are suitable with BVT, with ItalSens, with G-Sens, with CTI electrodes or OG carbon electrodes as well. So there are a lot of electrodes that use this type of connector. So now you see the different options how to connect the multiplexer. And this you can individually choose when you order your multiplexer. So you can choose which cable options you want. If you don't really know what you want to do with the multiplexer in the sense of you don't have one dedicated project, but you want to do a lot of different things with it, I recommend the double shielded cable with the 2mm banana plugs because it's just the most suitable for most cells and applications. Up to now, I told you you can connect up to 8 cells. That's actually not 100% correct, because if you get more multiplexers, you can combine them to connect more than 8 cells. So I have here one multiplexer and I have here a second multiplexer. To prepare it for being connected to another multiplexer, you need to remove the pins on the input. So I'll just remove these pins. Then you can put the two potentiostats on top of each other. And we put magnets in them, so they form a nice little unit. So even if you combine 4, 5, or 6 multiplexers, you will have a stable tower of multiplexers. To combine them, you need to combine the link port of the potentiostat that is connected to your potentiostat to the input port of the second multiplexer. So for that, I need a daisy chain cable. Let's connect it like this. This explains what was there. So now you've connected these and you can in principle do that for more. Then you would connect this link to the input of the next one and you can just go on. On the other side, you see that I have 4 ports and each of them supporting 4 cells. You can really stack up a lot of cells for your measurements. This is all I wanted to tell you about how to connect your multiplexer. If you go to our YouTube channel and subscribe, you will not miss any of our future videos. Or if you follow us on LinkedIn, for example, you will not miss the video where we explain how to use the multiplexer in our software PS Trace. So thanks for watching and have a great day.